Almost every industry has some type of administration fee that they pass on to the consumer, where most people will say, when it's referring to the car business, that we should not have dealer dock fees because that's part of doing business. In this video, I want to demonstrate exactly what a dock fee pays for. Can you negotiate a dock fee? What is the ethical amount dock fee that should be charged? And also how to properly ask a dealership what their fees are. So, with that being said, I have a list of things that I have went through over the last several months on my bills that have some sort of administration fee. Banks, hotels, merchant services, business insurance, title companies, mortgage companies, government licensing, security brokers, financial advisors, lease companies, boat sales, plane sales, travel companies, rental car companies, real estate, rental services. By the way, have you gotten a hospital bill anytime soon? All the way down to the pizza delivery people, which they don't get that money, the delivery people, right? You get something delivered, if it's fast food or Grubhub or DoorDash or anything like that, they charge a delivery fee, and then you have to tip on top of that. So depending on how many times you eat out per year, per 5 years, let's talk about 5 years for a car, you actually may pay more fees for that stuff than you would ever pay at a car dealership. But the biggest thing about this video is not about that stuff. It's just simply to show you that we have fees, and everything we do is explain what a dealer dock fee actually pays for. And I want to do it in a way that nobody has ever explained to you, probably in the history of the car business. Some examples what a dock fee actually pays for. Check vehicle safety, history, and titles. We're not going to go too much into depth on that. Provide a full condition information on the window label. Not too much into that as well. There are some costs when you print out labels and stuff for the cars. Discover and disclose accurate vehicle mileage. Okay, this one could be tricky and cost a dealership a lot of money, and this is not something that is in the normal course of doing business. I just experienced this. Have a car that some salespeople, I'm not gonna say my friend Joe Warner did this and made this mistake, but some salespeople will write down the wrong odometer. Well, if I'm selling a car with 3,000 miles and we wrote down 8,000, that's a big issue and we have to fix it. It's time consuming and it's expensive. So that's part of something that happens. Those should not happen, but they do. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge, Joe. Have you bought a car recently? It's almost worse than buying a house. There are so many forms that have to be printed to protect your interest and the dealership's interest, and those forms are not cheap. We have to process titles and plates. A lot of these times, we have to pay additional people, like runners, so to speak, to run to the DMV if it's an out-of-state deal. Like, we're in Louisville, Kentucky, so we deal with a lot of Indiana customers, so we have to overnight everything up to Indianapolis, get the title work done, all that good stuff. And of course, we know what a UPS or a FedEx envelope costs to mail. We have to file and clear liens, so when we have to file with the state that you're in, we have to get the title from the bank that you have your lien in. There's some costs associated with that. A lot of times you don't realize that they charge dealers a fee to mail us the title. It's silly, it's stupid, and that fee is something we have to absorb, which is what a dealer fee takes place of. This, I think, is the most important one, and when this is explained to you, you're gonna be like, you know what? Keep the money, I'm glad you're doing it. We collect a lot of personal data, personal information that is non-public. So therefore, we need a way to keep that secure. And those systems are extremely expensive. So we have to keep records, all sorts of things for the state, social security numbers, date of birth, things that you would not want anybody to get a hold of, and also to keep yourself protected so that way your credit is standing where it is. So we have a lot of systems in place through dealerships throughout the country to make sure that your information is stored and secure, along with other federal guidelines and state and local guidelines to do that stuff as well. We don't really have this much in Kentucky, but it is something that a dealership does pay for with your dealer dock fee that you pay them, and that would be do emissions testing and laws. Not so much here in Kentucky, but it is through many states in this awesome country. Also, pass along information including lemon law notices. Also, the big one is happens on every single car deal, with the exception of a few states because you don't have it, but process taxes on your purchase and also rebates. So we have to pay the sales tax on a monthly, quarterly, weekly, whatever basis based off of certain things. We have to write a check. If you don't know what a business check costs, you're talking about $1.50, $2 per business check in order to print that check. So also with the rebates of a dealership has, if we have a $3,000 rebate, the dealership actually floats that money to the manufacturer before we actually get paid. So if the manufacturer pays 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks on routine, then we have to float that money, which is money that we have to take out of the bank and yada, yada, yada. But that's something that a dealer doc fee pays as well. A lot of federal and state and local laws also require us to keep you informed of your rights and obligations. When you come into most dealerships and we take any type of non-public personal information, we hand you a form that is a full disclosure transparency form of what we do with your information, an opt-in or opt-out form, so that you're aware of what we do with your information, because it's the law. Kind of alluded to it earlier, but we keep a lot of good records. We have to, right? There's a lot of times customers will call us and say, hey, I don't have that paperwork anymore, can you get it for me? And we're like, yep, we sure got it. 5 years, 6 years, 7 years, depending on what the form is and whatnot. And nowadays, paper is expensive. It's a big fire hazard. So nowadays what we do is we typically scan all that stuff in, keep it in the cloud, and oh my God, there goes some right there. We gotta get that back. That's part of the dealer fee. We gotta get that social security number back. So, but anyways, keep it in the cloud with my lame joke. And that way, if you ever need it, we can download it, scan it, send it to you, whatever the case may be, if you ever need it. Maintain technology to process your paperwork faster. So some dealers could use a little bit of training on this, but in a nutshell, Indiana being one of those, since we have an Indiana dealer, we actually have a program over there that we get the title work done in just a couple days. So when I buy a car over there, and since I live in Indiana, I get everything done like in 2 or 3 days. So that's something that we have to pay for from the state of Indiana. Again, not a part of doing business, it's just a requirement that the state says, hey, you have to do this. Training the staff is expensive, it takes a lot of time, and it takes away from doing business. However, it's extremely important to train the staff of laws and stuff like that. So a lot of times dealers won't give you certain information because it's got their name on it and they have deeper pockets, and if you drop it, it's their butt on the line. And just so you know, a piece of paper could equal $1,000 all the way up to $11,000 per item if they're caught out of compliance. The attorney general, state and local officials catch stuff like that. It's extremely expensive to be out of compliance and cost the dealerships lots of money. So the training of our staff, which we do here on a regular basis, this is extremely important. And probably the last one is to maintain licenses. Several states throughout the country, Indiana not being one of them, Kentucky being one of them, we have fees in order to be a salesman. We have to have a license. I never experienced that until I moved here in 2008 with the state of Kentucky, that I actually have to have a car salesman license. That costs, fortunately, the dealership pays that. I don't have to pay that, but it's something that they probably recoup in the dealer doc fee as well. Now, my dealer doc fee currently in 2019 is $299.50. I think that is an extremely fair fee. I don't know anything. I'm presuming that this fee has been in force the entire time that I've been here since 2008, and I would assume that sometime that we've got to raise it, right? I was having a conversation about this a couple months ago with someone because I was gearing up to do this video. So if they raise it, say another $100, I think a $399 fee is extremely fair as well, based off the information that I just told you. And I know that people are going to comment, I know you're going to comment and say that it's a scam and stuff like that, and everything that I'm saying here goes into one ear and out the other as effectiveness, because again, kind of like I said at the beginning of the video, dealerships are always scrutinized. Even though you pay that delivery driver $2 and pay a $3 delivery fee, you know, $5 every time you order a sandwich or a meal for lunch or the family dinner or whatever the case may be, but nothing to dwell on that. I'm just trying to make a good point. So even a dealership having a $300 to $500 fee, I would say max, is pretty in normal depending on the size of the dealership and the things that they do for you. So let's talk about the, can you negotiate a dealer doc fee? And the answer is no, you really can't. And the reason you can't negotiate a dealer doc fee is because the dealerships are scared of everything out there. So imagine this, and again, I'm gonna say this kind of bluntly, I'm not gonna sugarcoat anything, because that's just the way I am, that's how I do business, and I don't want anybody to be triggered or take this out of context, I'm just using it as an analogy. Imagine if a man and a woman come by the exact same car, pay the exact same price, and the man does not pay a dealer doc fee, but the woman does. They find out, they sue the dealership. Who do you think would win? Or she would sue the dealership. Let's go to the next level. The stupidest level I think could possibly have, because I don't think this way and I don't do this, but imagine if a black person or a white person or an immigrant and somebody who's been in this country from day one, born in this country, who, whatever the case may be, right? There's all sorts of silly scenarios that dealerships are scared of. And this is the point that I want to get across. Dealerships are scared to get sued. Lawsuits are costly, lawsuits are expensive. I just went through one. It cost me a ton of money and I'm not really happy about it, but it is what it is. And that's what dealerships are scared of. So they will not take that fee off out of fear that they're gonna get sued for unfair business practices based off of equal opportunities, sex, religion, you know, all of that stuff, right? So don't go in there and expect that fee just to miraculously leave because of the fear of dealerships. So there is my spiel on dealer doc fees. Now I agree that a dealer doc fee is an ethical practice to have at a dealership within reason. I don't think going over $500 is an ethical number. I think anything over $500, you need to work the dealership and lower the fees like I taught you, of saying, hey, listen, let them have half of it. Let them have $300 if it's a $600 fee. If it's a $600 fee, let them have $200 of it. Whatever you feel comfortable with having, let them make a little bit of money. That's not a bad thing to keep in business. Remember, you may need them down the road and you don't realize it today. So having them having a little bit of profit and some money in a car deal is okay, as long as they're doing it ethically and not gouging you. So I hope this is informative. I look forward to your comments below. Remember, YouTube's algorithm, leave a big thumbs up on this video. I really appreciate it. If this is the first time that you're watching the video, hit the subscribe button, turn your bell notifications on. Go to thechevydudestore.com and get your Chevy Dude swag. Use the Amazon link in the description below, and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day. Thanks for watching. Drive safely.